بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Update and secrets in plain X-ray abdomen gases and air fluid level. Subjects include in this lecture 10 subjects. First, plain X-ray abdomen gas normally. Second, air fluid level algorithm in the abdomen. Gasless abdomen. Small bowel obstruction. Large bowel obstruction. Ileus. Gastric dilatation. Extraluminal abdomen gas, pneumoperitoneum. Extraluminal abdomen gases, retropneumoperitoneum. Specific organ gases, gas in specific organ, hepatobiliary and genitourinary. Protocol for brain X-ray abdomen gases study. We follow these steps to examine brain X-ray abdomen and collect data, and we reach to result. First, we do optimal radiographic techniques, at least two plain X-ray, two radiographs. First, supine abdominal radiograph after 10 minutes of standing. After we do supine abdominal radiograph, patient wait standing 10 minutes. We do either an erect image or left lateral decubitus image, included basal chest. Second, look for normal gas distribution. Third step, look for abnormal gas distribution. Search for abnormality include number of power loop containing gas, diameter or dilatation, air fluid levels number and distribution. Fourth step, look for abnormal gas distribution, if intraluminal or extraluminal or intramural, like or pneumoperitoneum. Fifth, look for abnormal intraluminal gas distribution of generalized or localized distribution. Six, if generalized distribution of gas, look for gas in rectum. If no gas in rectum, look for distribution of gases related to small or large bowel. If localized gas distribution, look for sentinel loop. If localized gas distribution, look for specific signs like abscess. Last, correlate all this data collected from brain X-ray abdomen, correlate all this with clinical picture. We must correlate this with clinical picture. This is 10 steps protocol for brain X-ray abdomen. Normal gas patterns in brain X-ray abdomen. The 3-6-9 rule reflect maximum diameter of the bowel. 3 meaning small bowel, maximum normal diameter 3 cm 30 mm. 6 mean large bowel, maximum normal diameter 50 to 60 mm. Cecum is 9 cm 90 mm maximum normal diameter. The radiographic evaluation of cystinal gas should include the following point: what segment of the bowel contains the gas, identify the gut mucosa outlined by the gas, most distal point the gas has passed in the intestine, dimension of the air-filled gut. Normal gas pattern present in the stomach always except supine film. Present in a small bowel, 2-3 loops of non-descending bowel. Present in larger bowel, in rectum or sigmoid colon, always gas seen, maybe not seen, non-gas normally in the bowel, large bowel. Normal gas pattern in the small bowel. First, we identify the segment, then identify the gut mucosa pattern. Small bowel segment centrally in the abdomen with an internal mucosal fold valvula confens plica circularis. This gut mucosa pattern. Jejunum characterized by valvula confens completely pass across the weeds. Completely pass across the weeds. Regularly spaced space between everyone is equal. Completely passing this white line across the weeds. Ilium is featureless. Cecum shown by a round gas shadow in right iliac fossa. Normal gas in the small bowel. Small bowel gas may be normal finding in some adult, also in preparation for dye investigation like IVB. Typically less quantity than stomach, large and large bowel, more rapidly absorbed through the wall. Gas in the small bowel, less in quantity than stomach and larger intestine, commonly seen through the center of the abdomen, the side. Most of small bowel not found, not fixed in place. It can have a wide variable location. Gasless small bowel may be normally seen. Gasless small bowel may be no gas in small bowel in some condition as we took later. Normal gas pattern in the large bowel, identified first site of segment extended by gas, then identify the gut mucosa pattern. Hostral outpouching, which is bordered by plica semilunaris, fold of colonic wall that project into lumen, this fold of colonic wall, this white line. Plica semilunaris extend only partially around the circumference of the bowel, don't extend all through, all the way across the lumen of the bowel, different from plica semilunaris of the small intestine, which is passing all through across width of the bowel. In the large bowel, this is plica semilunaris, not extend all through across lumen, extend only partially around the circumference, this white line, like this. This is white line, this is large bowel. Normal gas in the small bowel, gas filled hostral outpouching, gas frequently accompanied by vehicle material trapped within it, frequently produce mottled appearance. Gas air mixed with vehicle material giving mottled appearance. Column gas pattern usually distributed like picture frame around the periphery of the abdomen. Normal gas in the stomach. Orogeal fold of the stomach visible like wavy appearance, velvety appearance. Composition of gas in the stomach very similar of the air we breathe. Air in the stomach similar to air breathe. Picture of normal air in the atmosphere. Gastric fundus fixed in location, typically measure 2.5 cm of the left hemidiaphragm. Gastric fundus fixed in position, distance between left hemidiaphragm usually 2.5 cm. A sign of stomach dilatation is inferior displacement of the transverse colon, may be displaced all the way into the pelvis. This is normal gas pattern image. Normal gas in stomach, gas in few bowel loops normally central, gas in the rectum and sigmoid normally may be seen fixed with vicar material. This is normal supine abdomen, normal gas in the gut in the abdomen. Normal gas in the abdomen as in colon, small bowel central, in colon peripheral. We see in colon plica semilunaris project hostral pouching partially into lumen. This is central small bowel, small in diameter than large bowel. Normal X-ray abdomen, bowel gas pattern normally, stomach, small bowel, peripheral large bowel. Normal X-ray plain abdomen film, soft tissue densities like kidney densities, psoas muscle margin. This is blue outlined point to normal gas muscle margin, psoas muscles, air fluid level in the abdomen. Is another subject. Air fluid level in the abdomen not always mean air fluid level in the bowel. This is one of the home message. Air fluid level in the abdomen in play X-ray abdomen not always mean air fluid level in the bowel. Air fluid level in the bowel means disturbed bowel motility plus or minus intestinal obstruction. By mean, not air fluid level on the bowel in the play X-ray abdomen meaning intestinal obstruction. Air fluid level in the bowel meaning disturbed bowel motility like in gastroenteritis. Air fluid level in the bowel meaning disturbed bowel motility plus or minus intestinal obstruction. Air fluid level in the bowel in plain X-ray abdomen may be seen in gastroenteritis without obstruction. Air fluid level in the abdomen may be normally seen or pathological. Pathological air fluid level in the abdomen in plain X-ray abdomen may be functional or organic. Organic means mechanical dynamic obstruction. Air fluid level in pre-X-ray abdomen meaning motility disorder. This motility disorder may be hypomotility, diminished peristalsis as in gastroenteritis, absent peristalsis as in ileus, non-propulsive peristalsis as in mesenteric vascular occlusion. Organic air fluid level in the abdomen, mechanical intestinal obstruction, divided into large bowel obstruction, small bowel obstruction, decompressed large bowel obstruction. Site or fluid level in the abdomen, either central as in small bowel obstruction, or peripheral as in large bowel obstruction, or generalized as in ileus, or in specific site as in abscess, sentinel lobe, hydropneumoperitoneum. Any air fluid level in the large bowel are considered abnormal, indicate diminished, lost bowel transport either due to obstruction or a loss of diminished peristalsis. Air fluid level in erect abdomen X-ray more than 5 fluid level greater than 2.5 cm in length is abnormal, associated with motility disorder as in obstruction, ileus, ischemia, diminished peristalsis as in gastroenteritis. Abdomen X-ray is 50% sensitive for acute obstruction. Fluid level appear little than gas shadow. 3 fluid level in small bowel considered normal. Number of fluid level is proportional to the degree of obstruction and distal site in small bowel. A few air fluid level in the absence of abnormal abdominal sign and symptom are usually not clinically significant. Differential diagnosis of air fluid level in the abdomen, bowel motility disorder, abscess, hydropneumoperitoneum. We see in this appendicitis case, air fluid level in the lower abdomen, finding not specific but routinely localized inflammatory process. Abnormal abdominal gas pattern, either intramural or gasless abdomen, intraluminal as intestinal obstruction in the air fluid level, extraluminal air as in pneumoperitoneum, pneumoretroperitoneum. Abnormal abdominal gas pattern in pre-X-ray abdomen may present in four picture. First, intramural in the wall or gasless or intraluminal or extraluminal air. Gasless abdomen. Gasless abdomen in adult is often interpreted as non-specific. A specific cause of the gasless abdomen can usually be mood when the patient history known. Most serious cause of gasless abdomen is small bowel obstruction with or without ischemia. Gasless abdomen may be normally seen. maybe have many causes. Gasless abdomen must be correlated with clinical picture. Most common serious cause is small bowel obstruction without ischemia causing gasless abdomen. Common causes include small bowel obstruction, bowel ischemia, congenital atresia, situs, pancreatitis, gastroenteritis, large abdominal mass, little small bowel gas may be normal finding in adult. Large abdominal mass due to displacement post-surgery following total colectomy, gastrectomy, esophageal gastrectomy, and low anterior resection. Normal gasless small bowel may be normally seen. This is old woman with severe abdominal point and vomiting, small bowel obstruction. Supine abdomen show paucity of gas in the right side of the abdomen with air containing jejunum that has fold thickening. This is gasless abdomen. This is supine abdominal show gasless field, gas field in stomach in gasless abdomen. Classic finding of ascites, increased density over the abdomen, central location of few lobes of contrast field small bowel, loss of normal fat outlining posterior liver edge, loss of all other normal fat planes. This is gasless abdomen in ascites. Intestinal obstruction. Intestinal obstruction leading to vigorous peristalsis, which leading to flaccidity of bowel, causing distension with gas to occur proximal to the obstruction, causing gaseous distension, which is hallmark of small bowel obstruction, leading to lastly multiple air fluid level in erect abdomen X-ray. Few air fluid level in the absence of abnormal abdominal gas and symptom, usually not clinically significant. This one of the home message. If no sign or symptom, air fluid level few in the absence of this sign or symptom, not clinically significant. In assessing bowel gas pattern imaging study, we must answer three questions. There is air in the rectum or sigmoid, lobes dilated small or large bowel, abnormal air related to bowel, intramural, intraluminal, or free in the peritoneum. Intestinal obstruction cause either functional as in functional areas or mechanical or as in dynamic obstruction. Functional ileus result from atony of the intestine with loss of normal peristalsis in the absence of a mechanical cause, leading to localized sentinel loops or generalized adynamic functional ileus. So functional intestinal obstruction either localized or generalized. Mechanical intestinal obstruction, mechanical dynamic obstruction, peristalsis working against a mechanical obstruction, present either small bowel obstruction SBO, large bowel obstruction LBO, or decompressed large bowel in a small bowel. Intestinal obstruction duration, either acute, subacute, chronic. Intestinal obstruction may be partial or complete. Intestinal obstruction transient or permanent. Intestinal obstruction type may be simple or complex, as in closed loop strangulation. Intestinal obstruction type may be low, intestinal obstruction or high. Intestinal obstruction mechanical causes divided into intraluminal causes in the bowel, intramural in the pool of the bowel, or extramural extraluminal causes. Intraluminal causes as impacted faces, foreign body, gallstone ileus. Intramural malignant or inflammatory structure, extramural as in adhesion, peritoneal band, strangulated hernia, vulvus interception. Mechanical intestinal obstruction causes either simple no vascular compromise, strangulation obstruction with vascular compromise, or closed loops both ends obstructed. Intestinal obstruction in brain X-ray either have a specific sign we diagnose as intestinal obstruction or no specific sign. So another home message, if no specific sign present in intestinal obstruction brain X-ray, not diagnose intestinal obstruction without clinical picture. We look, as we see before, air in the rectum. Air in the rectum not present, air in small bowel, we diagnose small bowel obstruction. Air in large bowel, we diagnose large bowel obstruction, or decompressed large bowel obstruction, air present in both bowels, small and large. If we look for air in the rectum and we found air in the rectum, then we look for distended loops, either few as localized ileus central loop or generalized multiple as in generalized ileus, air in the rectum, one of the key in diagnosis of intestinal obstruction. In intestinal obstruction, we found site of obstruction, most distal point. Proximal to it, we found dilated segment of loop, distal to this point, collapsed loop. And air fluid level present proximally to site of obstruction in dilated loops. According to Laplace's law, maximum pressure is at the maximum diameter area. Cecum is the greatest risk for perforation. Bowel gas pattern to differentiate between small bowel obstruction and large bowel obstruction. The distribution of loop in small bowel central, large bowel peripheral. Number of loop in small bowel multiple, large bowel few. Valvular conveyance, complete line, small bowel obstruction, hostra incomplete, in large bowel obstruction. Diameter less than 5 cm in small bowel, more than 5 cm in large bowel. Radius of curvature small in small bowel, large in large bowel. Solid faces absent in small bowel, present in large bowel. Small bowel obstruction. Causes of small bowel obstruction, either intramural causes like inflammatory stricture, ischemia, primary small bowel tumor, or intraluminal causes, gallstones, foreign bodies. Extrinsic causes of small bowel obstruction, adhesion most common, postoperative adhesions, hernias, masses, congenital malrotation. Clinical presentation of small bowel obstruction. Abdominal pain, squealing bowel sound, early obstruction, no bowel sound, bowel wall muscular exclusion, rapid onset of nausea and vomiting, belching, abdominal rigidity, abdominal swelling, constipation. Probability of correct diagnosis by Blaine film vary from 55% to 80% in small bowel obstruction. Small bowel obstruction appearance indicating first gasless abdomen, small bowel appearances indicating small bowel obstruction, first gasless abdomen, one of specific or sensitive signs of small bowel obstruction. Second signs appear after 3 to 5 hours. Marked after 12 hours in brain film, include small bowel dilated over 30 mm with little or no gas in colon and spine abdominal x-ray. First sign in small bowel obstruction is gasless abdomen. Signs in small bowel obstructions appear after 3 to 5 hours or even after 12 hours in brain film. First small bowel dilatation over 30 mm. Multiple air fluid level in small bowel, steep leader appearance in erect film. Stitch or slit sign. String of pearl sign seen in decubitus or upright film and is virtually diagnostic of small bowel obstruction. Coiled spring sign. Small bowel faces sign. Disproportionate dilatation of a small bowel. This is signs of small bowel obstruction in plain X-ray abdomen film. Hallmark of small bowel obstruction is gaseous distension of small bowel loops. 3 or more L fluid level in small bowel are considered abnormal. This is result of diminished and lost bowel transport. Result and obstruction or loss diminished peristalsis will be the cause. Small bowel distension considered present if loops greater than 3 cm in diameter. Abdomen X-ray 50% sensitive for acute obstruction. So 3 or more air fluid level are considered abnormal in small bowel. Small bowel dilatation or distension means the diameter greater than 3 cm. Normal air-filled small bowel. Appearance of small bowel visualized in left iliac fossa. Result of normal air swallowing. This is normal appearance of air bowel. Appearance like in the crazy puffing or pattern of an agraph. Appear as interlocking random tessellated pattern. This is normal air filled small bowel, like crazy puffing or pattern on the grave. Meteorism, excessive swallowing of air, particularly common crying children and hyperventilating adult. It's normally this prominent bowel loops. No cut-off point, bowel has been likened like crazy puffing. Air swallowing simulating intestinal obstruction. Anxiety during injection of contrast material for IVB. This is caused by transient ingestion of air, is bowel normal. Appear in 5 minute liters. Minimally dilated small bowel. 36 mm evidence of loss of normal random tessellated pattern associated with undilated small bowel. This may represent early small bowel obstruction or partial small bowel obstruction. Gasless small bowel obstruction. Gasless sign. Gasless fluid filled dilated small bowel. This is fluid filled looking white. All air absorbed, opaque looking small bowel loops filled by fluid. It's one sign of a small bowel obstruction. Opaque looking small bowel filled with a normal small bowel content, difficult to differentiate with normal bowel loops. Small bowel dilatation more than 3 mm. Reach exceed 5 cm in diameter, mistaken for large bowel obstruction. This is this central with hostra complete through the walls. This small bowel dilatation is a hallmark of small bowel obstruction, hallmark sign. Gasless abdomen, old boy primitive small bowel obstruction. Small bowel with the amount of barium present in the right colon and rectum from prior study to operation. Lack of gas in small bowel, gasless abdomen, opaque small bowel. CT show dilated small bowel completely filled with fluid. Fluid replace air, so looking opaque in plain X-ray. Obstruction due to dense adhesion in this patient. Gasless abdomen, old woman with history of lymphoma. Gasless abdomen, sign of small bowel obstruction. This is old woman after operation, 6 months after operation. We show paucity of gas throughout abdomen. Surgical steps, opaque abdomen. Because of replacement of air, small bowel with fluid. Markedly dilated central loops of small bowel with effacement of valvuli in the mid-abdomen, small bowel obstruction. Markedly distended loops of small bowel obstruction, centrally distributed. Within the small bowel, linear collection of gas bubbles, known as string of pearls sign. This indicator of mechanical small bowel obstruction, string of pearls sign, row of small air bubble which represent air trapped between valvuli, string of pearls sign left lateral decubitus, string of pearls sign curvilinear arrangement of air bubble visualized caused by small bubble of air trapped in valvuli of small bowel, diagnostic of obstruction opposite to what present in ileus, horizontal decubitus ray X-ray film show string of pearls sign, stiff leather sign caused by air fluid level in erect abdomen, dilated small bowel loop with multiple air fluid level, string of pearls more fluid inside of the loop than other, diagnostic disproportionate distribution of gases in small bowel obstruction, stiff leather pattern caused by air fluid level in erect abdomen, coiled spring sign occurs in dilated field small bowel, most not seen in jejunum where valvula closely spaced, coiled spring sign, slit stretch sign, slit sign of small amount of air in the valvula of fluid filled bowel, small amount of air in the valvula of filled bowel, subtle fluid filled loop of small bowel and slit sign highly suggestive of small bowel obstruction. This is small amount of air in fluid filled bowel, slit sign, dilated ileal occlusion, postoperative adhesion, classic small bowel obstruction sign, gas filled jejunal and ileal segment dilated, prominent valvuli, right colon contain gases but not distended, tangential view of external hernia, to presence of air in a small bowel obstruction due to hernia, to extra abdominal gases in small bowel, a result of herniation of small bowel, small bowel obstruction secondary to intraperitoneal fibrous band adhesion, multiple central air fluid level, erect film show multiple air fluid level in small bowel with different height of air fluid level with in the same loop, small bowel obstruction, small bowel ischemia secondary to fibrous adhesion, multiple air fluid level central within distribution of small bowel in small bowel obstruction, central distinction of small bowel loops, we found postoperative metal clips, mechanical small bowel obstruction supine position, dilated central small bowel loop, little gas on colon, especially rectum, this disproportionate dilatation of small bowel in small bowel obstruction, small bowel obstruction secondary to adhesion, supine film show dilated small bowel with characteristic distributions and mucosal pattern without any air fluid level. We do erect film for the same patient. We found large amount of fluid and air fluid level, three multiple small pockets of air arranged in a line noted left lower quadrant, residual colonic gas, multiple air fluid level in erect small bowel obstruction, multiple air fluid level in brain X-ray abdomen, air fluid level in abdominal X-ray more than 5 fluid level greater than 2.5 centimeter in length is abnormally associated with obstruction, ileus, ischemia, or gastroenteritis, This patient show small bowel obstruction, small bowel obstruction supine, distended dilated small bowel, distended with air, loops of small bowel dilated central, associated with small calcific nodules, seen right iliac fossa, in appendicitis, appendiculus, appendicular mass, patient present with small bowel obstruction, markedly distended loops of small bowel, with effacement of the valvuli in mid-abdomen, this appendicitis complicated by peritonitis and adhesion, dilated loops of small bowel, but concretion and concentration several loops of small bowel in the right hypochondrium. This is suggestive of male rotation, mid-gut volvulus caused by male rotation, stack coins, steep ladder appearance, this mechanical small bowel obstruction. These two signs present. Small bowel obstruction, centrally located multiple dilated loops of gas bowel in small bowel, dilated reach to 5 cm in diameter, evidence of valvuli, mucosal pattern of small bowel, strangulated obstruction as a result of hernia, sternal obstruction show dilated loop of a small bowel associated with second edematous valvuli, strangulated left inguinal hernia, strangulated obstruction, dilated small bowel loops with obstructed bowel in the right inguinal region, gallstone ileus, one of causes of small bowel obstruction, mechanical intestinal obstruction due to impaction of gallstone in the intestine, 2% of small bowel obstruction caused by gallstone ileus, impaction of gallstone in terminal ileum after passing through a biliary enteric fistula. Gallstone ileus, mechanical intestinal obstruction due to impaction of gallstone in the intestine, 2% of causes of small bowel obstruction. Impaction of gallstone in terminal ileum after passing through biliary enteric fistula. Classic radiographic signs of gallstone ileus according to regular striate: 1. Gas within biliary duct and gallbladder. 2. Incomplete or complete small bowel obstruction. 3. Ectopic location of gallstone. This triad diagnosis of gallstone ileus may be first sign in seen in this triad is ectopic gallbladder stone. When we see ectopic gallbladder stone, we go back to liver, search for gas in biliary tree. Gallstone ileus, gas in gallbladder biliary tree, small bowel obstruction, ectopic gallbladder stone. Interception, one of causes of a small bowel obstruction, commonly seen in children below 2 years. Colocolic and ileoileal interception may occur, common in the ileum due to inflammation of lymphoid tissue and Peyer's patch. Adult usually secondary to tumor of the bowel. Interceptions, ileum telescope inside ascending colon, obstructing passage of intestinal content causing small bowel obstruction. Blood vessels become trapped between layers. Blood flow decreases, leading to edema, strangulation of bowel, gangrene, sepsis, shock, and finally death if not managed. Ileocolic segment involved in 90% of cases of interception. Interception forming of interceptum and intercipient. Interceptum, its part, invaginated inside, and interceptions part includes this invaginated part, enfolding part. One segment of the distant telescopes interceptum inside another intercepium, causing external obstruction. So we say shaped lump concavity towards umbilicus. Interception small bowel obstruction signs. Crescent sign soft tissue mass sometimes surrounded by a crescent of gas, most commonly in right hypochondrium. Target sign two concentric circles of fat density laying to the right of spine. Target sign twist as common as crescent sign. Brain film show absent cecal gas. Barium enema claw sign in barium enema. This is prominent crescent sign in left upper quadrant. Subtle target sign in right upper quadrant. Incipient interceptions in the left upper quadrant in brain film in infant with pain and vomiting. We sound this is interceptum inside incipient part. Inceptions in barium enema. Intraluminal crescentic feeling defect. Outer surface may be show a rim of barium similar to coiled spring. Coiled spring reduction can be achieved. Intraluminal crescentic feeling defect. This is classic crescent sign child with ileocolic interceptions. Crescent air sign in the left hypochondrium. This is point subtle target sign of interception. Crescent sign obscured by adjacent bowel gas. Target sign abdominal ultrasound show target sign in interceptions. Pitfalls in mechanical small bowel obstruction. Early small bowel obstruction may resemble localized ileus. Small intestinal infarction caused by thrombosis or embolism of superior mesenteric artery. In brain X-ray we show this finding. Signs: first, gas filled dilated loops with multiple fluid level. Second, the bowel loop eyeing to submucosal edema or hemorrhage. Linear gas streaks in wall streaks suggesting gangrene. Free gas if perforation. Intraluminal gas in mesenteric veins or portal vein in advanced cases. Intramural gas, gas in the wall with positive irregular sign due to intraperitoneal gas suggests the possibility of intestinal obstruction. Intraluminal gas in the wall of the bowel. Low of gut. Most patients with a mechanical obstruction will present with some form of abdominal pain, abdominal distension, and constipation. Patient may present with vomiting early in the course of a proximal small bowel obstruction and later in the course of illness with a distal small bowel obstruction. Prolonged obstruction with persistently elevated intraluminal pressure can lead to vascular compromise, necrosis, perforation in the affected loop of bowel. Let's look at each of four abdominal bowel gas patterns in detail. For each of these four abnormality, look at their pathophysiology, causes, imaging feature, diagnostic pitfalls. Complication of bowel obstruction, strangulation, ischemia, necrosis, perforation, peritonitis, and death. Difference between high and low intestinal obstruction. Large intestinal obstruction, colonic obstruction. Large intestinal obstruction either divided into functional ileus, acute, colonic, and pseudo obstruction, or mechanical dynamic obstruction. Carcinoma of colon 60%, diverticulitis second most common, Volvulus hernia, strangulated hernia, inception, extrinsic compression, vehicle obstruction. Types of large bowel obstruction, type 1, complete comitant ileocecal valve, cecal distension, cecum at risk of perforation. Type 2, large and small bowel distension, incomitant valve, large bowel, bowel obstruction decompressed into small bowel, leading to distinction of both large and small bowel. Mechanical large bowel obstruction signs: dilated colon to point of obstruction more than 5-6 mm, little or no air in rectum sigmoid, little or no gas in small bowel of ileocecal valve remains concomitant, large bowel string of pearls sign, air fluid level. Large bowel obstruction decompressed into small bowel when concomitant ileocecal valve present. We found the gas in large bowel may decompress in the small bowel, giving a small bowel obstruction appearance. Follow up. Bowel obstruction, we found central peripheral large dilated colon with its typical mucosal pattern, incomplete hystra. Large bowel obstruction decompressed into small bowel, concomitant ileocecal valve allowed air in large bowel to pass into small bowel, giving appearance of large and small bowel obstruction in the plain X-ray. Distinction: diameter of large bowel more than 5 cm. It is a sign of bowel obstruction, colonic obstruction, peripheral, incomplete hostrations. Colonic obstruction do not commonly give rise to small bowel fluid level unless advanced. Barium follows through is contraindicated in acute intestinal obstruction. Lack of gas in rectum not a reliable sign of bowel obstruction. Equally, gas in rectum do not exclude bowel obstruction. Collapsed distal large bowel more reliable sign for bowel obstruction. Large bowel string of Peyer's sign. We found plica semilunaris of large bowel larger than valvuli of small bowel. Pockets of air tend to be larger. Also, because you are larger in the large bowel, surface tension and able to make them around, instead they tend to have flat underside. Large bowel obstruction, distended colonic with its mucosal appearance, its distribution peripherally. Mechanical large bowel obstruction. Mechanical large bowel obstruction, distended large bowel colon with its mucosal incomplete hostration pattern, peripheral distribution, sigmoid carcinoma causing large bowel obstruction decompressed into small bowel. So we found appearance of both large and small bowel obstruction. Sigmoid carcinoma causing colonic obstruction. Multiple dilated loops of bowel with scattered air fluid level in upright film. Caliber and location of bowel suggests that air within the colon. Some small intestinal gas noted in the right mid abdomen, but preponderance of air inside colon. Little rectal gas seen. Colonic cut off sign. Abrupt termination of gas pattern within the proximal colon at the level of radiographic splenic fracture, at level of splenic fracture and decompression of distal colon, dilated transverse colon to splenic fracture associated with pancreatitis. Barium enema show abrupt obstruction of level of sigmoid colon, sigmoid carcinoma causing colonic obstruction, large bowel obstruction spine film, gas distribution in small and large bowel, sausage-like appearance of some loops, air fluid level, this is vehicle obstruction, large bowel volvulus. Sigmoid colon and cecum most common sites. If twister greater than 360 degree, unlikely to resolve spontaneously. Risk of vascular compromise more important than mechanical effect. Compound volvulus involving interweaving of two loops of bowel rear such as iliosigmoid node. We found sigmoid volvulus and cecal volvulus. Sigmoid volvulus only move upward and usually goes to the right upper quadrant. Cecal volvulus, however, can go almost anywhere, can be even located in the pelvis. This area of twist in sigmoid and cecum, volvulus extend away from area of bowel twist. Cecal volvulus, meaning torsion of the bowel around its mesentery and often result in closed lobe obstruction. Cecal volvulus occurs due to development failure of peritoneal fixation, account for 2 to 3% of cases of IO sinal obstruction and 11% of colonic volvulus, seen when cecum and ascending colon are in a mesentery. Cecum twist and invert in 50% in the other half twist occurs in an axial plane. Cecum twist in the axial plane, rotating clockwise or counterclockwise around its long axis. At times cecum twist invert and occupy left upper quadrant. Plane radiograph of cecal volvulus. Plane film diagnostic in about 75%. Dilated air filled cecum nectopic location, usually with the cecal apex in the left upper quadrant. Kidney or cuff pain appearance due to medially placed ileocecal valve reducing soft tissue indentation. Little gas in distal colon usually collapsed. Refluxed gas may erroneously suggest small bowel obstruction. This is cuff pain appearance, distended, large, viscous, filled with gas and the fluid, cecal volvulus, one or two hostral marking, left side of colon is collapsed. This cecal volvulus, apex of cecum in the left upper quadrant. Even so, there is considerable distension of the cecum. One or two hostral marking can be usually seen, unlike sigmoid volvulus. Identification attached gas filled appendix confirms the diagnosis. Besides diffuse dilatation of the bowel, major finding is large air containing structure in the pelvis, cecal volvulus. Typical cecal volvulus, notice that dilated bowel point toward the area of twist, which is area where you expect cecum to be located. Sigmoid volvulus account for 60-70% of colonic volvulus. Most type of colonic volvulus is sigmoid, classically in all the age. Psychiatrically disturbed, mentally retarded, institutional people, twist around mesenteric axis, rarely with axial torsion, twist around mesenteric axis, sigmoid volvulus. Sigmoid volvulus finding. As we see in this image, this direction of sigmoid volvulus, area of twist, directed to left side, anticlockwise rotation, around its mesenteric axis. Sigmoid volvulus finding dilated loop of sigmoid colon that was have inverted U configuration with absent hostral marking, important diagnostic point, opposite to cecal volvulus which has at least two hostral marking, left flank overlap sign, liver overlap sign, apex under left hemidiaphragm, apex above 10th thoracic vertebrae, inferior convergence on left, coffee bean sign in sigmoid volvulus, perium enema show paired of Bray sign. This is sigmoid anticlockwise direction of twist, band of adhesion in peridiverticulitis, overloaded pelvic colon, long pelvic mesocolon, narrow attachment of pelvic mesocolon. This is example of sigmoid volvulus, large distended air containing bowel. This is dilated loop of sigmoid, dilated loop of sigmoid has inverted U shape configuration, absent hostral marking, important diagnostic point, left flank overlap sign, liver overlap sign, apex under left hemidiaphragm, apex above 10th thoracic vertebrae, inferior convergence on left. This is classic appearance with all signs of sigmoid volvulus. Single line formed by host lateral wall, double line formed by medial wall. Single line formed by lateral wall, double line formed by medial wall with adjacent areas of twist. This is old sigmoid volvulus, diagnostic dilated loop of sigmoid, inverted U configuration, absent hostral marking, left flank overlap sign, liver overlap sign, apex under left hemidiaphragm, apex above 10th thoracic vertebrae, inferior convergence to the left. Coffee bean sign of sigmoid volvulus consists of a greatly distended air-filled loop of sigmoid extending from pelvis. Oblique line that's formed by the opposition of medial wall of dilated loop resemble cleft of coffee bean. This is oblique line resulting cleft of coffee bean formed by adjacent loop to the sigmoid volvulus segment. Coffee bean appear in the pelvis and its apex can be at 10th level of the to the left or right of middle line. Thoracic 10th level vertebrae level. This is sigmoid volvulus, colon appear dilated filled, inverted U shape, no hostral mark extend from pelvis into mid upper abdomen with coffee bean sign. This is sigmoid volvulus, most common colonic volvulus, water soluble enema confirm distal obstruction, discovered early colonoscopic decompression effective. Sigmoid volvulus, U-shaped configurations, extend from pelvis to upper abdomen. Sigmoid volvulus, not inverted U configuration, distended sigmoid extending from pelvis upway into right upper quadrant. Key finding dilatation of the proximal colon. Dilated loop seen in the left side is the dilated transverse colon. EB supine erect demonstrate characteristic coffee bean sign in sigmoid volvulus. Dilated loop point toward sigmoid area. Coffee bean sign. Sigmoid volvulus in the abdominal X-ray difficult to recognize. It's going on since so many bowel loop dilated in this case. Differential diagnosis. Differential diagnosis of large bowel obstruction. colonic pseudo obstruction. Ogilvie syndrome is acute dilatation of the colon. No mechanical obstruction in severely ill patient due to colon autonomic imbalance. Colonic pseudo obstruction, dilated colon with no mechanical obstruction. Colonic pseudo obstruction, massive dilatation of the cecum diameter more than 10 cm in the right colon, and this is abdominal X-ray. Acute abdominal distension within T day of respiratory pathology. Contrast in MCT required to exclude mechanical obstruction. Acute colitis. Assessment of extent of colitis, state of mucosa, depth of ulceration, presence, absence, toxic megacolon perforation, extent of vehicle residue related to extent of colitis, empty abdomen, no vehicle residue or gas with active total colitis, intraluminal gas tended to accumulate as colitis progress, acute ulcerative colitis, descending colon with irregular outline, absent obstruction, absent vehicle residue. Toxic megacolon, plain abdomen radiograph show the distension of transverse colon associated with mucosal edema, thumb printing, maximum transverse diameter of transverse colon 6 cm. Ischemic colitis, submucosal thickening with crescentic margin, thumb printing, involved area act as a functional obstruction, so proximal part frequently distended. Ischemic colitis. This involving area, ischemic area, act as functional obstruction, so bowel proximal it dilated. Extensive hostral thickening in a patient with pseudomembranous colitis. Ileus. Ileus, hypomotility of gastrointestinal tract in the absence of mechanical bowel obstruction. Functional ileus, one or more loops of bowel lose their ability to propagate peristaltic wave of the bowel, cause local irritation or inflammation, cause functional type of obstruction proximal to the affected loops. This ileus, hypomotility disorder without organic intestinal obstruction. Paralytic ileus, intestinal obstruction types, either localized ileus, called sentinel loops, affect only one or two loop, usually small bowel, characterized by gas in rectum or sigmoid. Generalized adynamic ileus, affect all loop of large and small bowel, frequently stomach, gas in rectum, long air fluid level. Paralytic ileus divided with absent peristalsis paralytic ileus or non-propulsive peristalsis mesenteric vascular occlusion. Paralytic ileus intestinal obstruction causes classic 5 P's are post-operative generalized adynamic ileus, peritonitis generalized adynamic ileus, potassium low, disturbance of electrolyte generalized adynamic ileus, pelvic spinal fracture generalized ileus, parturition, piles, pain, protein low causing generalized ileus. Few P's that can be included: pancreatitis, localized ileus left upper quadrant, Parkinson medication generalized ileus, painkiller the opioids generalized ileus, appendicitis cause localized ileus right lower right iliac fossa, cholecystitis cause localized ileus in upper outer quadrant, upper right hypochondrium, diverticular disease cause localized ileus. Although this is appendicitis, cholecystitis, diverticulitis, pancreatitis causing localized ileus sentinel loop. localized ileus signs. One, in brain X-ray, there is one or two persistent dilated loop of small bowel. Persistent means that this is same loop remain dilated multiple view of the abdomen, supine and the prone or supine and the upright abdomen. Although serial study over course of time, this is meaning of localized ileus. Dilated means small bowel loop persistently larger than 2.5 cm. Usually don't dilate it greatly as the switch mechanically obstructed. So persistent dilatation. Meaning of persistent, meaning of dilatation. Infrequently, central loop may be large bowel rather than small bowel, as in cecum appendicitis. Frequently, ill-filled level seen in central loop. Gas in the rectum or sigmoid in localized ileus. Non-specific finding radiographically may be seen. Beat false differentiating localized ileus from early small bowel obstruction. Localized ileus may resemble early mechanical obstruction. There may be a few dilated loop of small bowel with air in the colon seen in both. Early mean patient had symptom for a day or two. Patient who have had obstructive symptom for a week or more usually no longer demonstrate imaging find of early obstruction. Differentiation clinically, laboratory finding CT scan of the abdomen to differentiate between localized ileus and the early small bowel obstruction. Localized ileus sentinel loop. One or two persistent dilated loop of large or small bowel, gas in rectum and sigmoid. Sentinel loop. Isolated one or two lobe distended small bowel, sentinel loop. Irritative process like inflammatory process near the loop as being keratitis and appendicitis. Vocal area of a dynamic ileus. Close to the appendix, location of the right lower quadrant. In patient with abdominal pain and tenderness, sentinel loop in acute appendicitis. Sentinel loop from pancreatitis, localized area of dilated bowel. Sentinel loop, localized loop of small bowel, dilated in this patient's acute pancreatitis. Appearance diagnostic intra-abdominal inflammation. Sentinel loop, persistent dilatation of loop of small bowel, same location. This is normal colonic gas. This sentinel loop. Sentinel loop sign. Dilated loop of small bowel acute pancreatitis. Vocal area of a dynamic ileus in an isolated small bowel segment. Generalized a dynamic ileus. Entire bowel, usually air containing, may not dilated or dilated. Both large and small bowel, stomach may be dilated as well. So entire bowel in generalized ileus affected, air containing, may not dilated or dilated in ileus. Absence of peristalsis and the continued production of intestinal secretion produce many long air fluid level in the bowel. Not like mechanical obstruction, there should be gas in the rectum or sigmoid. Bowel sound frequently absent or hypoactive. Differentiation small bowel obstruction from paralytic ileus. Etiology in SBO patient with prior surgery week 2 years before. In ileus, recent surgery postoperative within hour. Being in SBO cloaky in ileus, not prominent feature. Abdominal distension SCBO frequently prominent may not be apparent in ileus. Bowel sound increased in SCBO absent in ileus. Small bowel dilatation present in SCBO present in ileus. Large bowel dilatation absent in SCBO present in generalized ileus. Pitfalls in generalized adynamic ileus. Patient may not present to emergency department with agilized dynamic areas unless they in two conditions. Two-day post-operative abdominal gynecologic surgery, severe electrolyte imbalance, as in hypokalemia. Many patients who have either intestinal pseudo-obstruction or erophagia may be not differentiated or give weight falls with generalized dynamic ileus. Small intestinal ileus, inverted U-shaped gaseous dilated small bowel observed above one another in the middle of the abdomen, double arrow point to air fluid level in the intestine. This is multiple loops of minimally dilated small bowel, minimal colonic gas, air fluid level, different level with same loop intestine upright film. Generalized dynamic ileus, gas in dilated small bowel and large bowel to rectum, multiple air fluid level. Generalized dynamic ileus, multiple dilated small and large bowel loop with air in the rectum and sigmoid. Generalized ileus, multiple dilated loop, small large bowel with air in the rectum and sigmoid. Very little gas in the colon, that is small bowel markedly dilated, that this loops vertically oriented. Yellow arrow point to multiple air fluid level, and this is patient obstructive ileus. This is multiple air fluid in this patient scene. This is read both small and large bowel dilated. Loop have relatively horizontal orientation. This is patient had paralytic or non-obstructive ileus with gas extending all the way to the rectum. This is read arrow point to hostra that do not traverse diameter of bowel indicating dilated loop of this likely colon. Blue arrow point traversing diameter of dilated small bowel. Generalize a dynamic ileus in supine film. Generalize a dynamic ileus, large and small bowel extensively air filled but not dilated. Generalize a dynamic ileus supine and upright film. Generalized ileus. Intestinal pseudo obstruction syndrome. Intestinal pseudo obstruction syndrome, meaning severe impairment in the ability of intestine to push food through, clinically present with suggestive of mechanical obstruction, clinically present as mechanical obstruction, abdominal pain, nausea, severe distension, vomiting, dysphagia, diarrhea, constipation, in the absence of any demonstrable evidence of intestinal obstruction, it's diagnosed. Intestinal pseudo obstruction, either acute colonic pseudo obstruction, acute colonic ileus, or Guillain-Barré syndrome, or chronic colonic pseudo obstruction. Intestinal pseudo obstruction, either primary idiopathic or inherited, injury to smooth muscle myopathic, injury nervous system neuropathic of GIT, or secondary Parkinson's disease, Sheik's disease, Hirschsprung, stinal hypogangliosis, collagen vascular disease, mitochondrial disease, endocrine disorder, certain medication causing it, enteric neuropathy. Acute colonic pseudo obstruction syndrome, colon may become massively dilated if it is not decompressed. Patient risk of perforation, peritonitis, and death, mortality rate up to 40% when perforation occurs. Chronic colonic pseudo obstruction, criteria for chronic colonic pseudo obstruction, symptom of recurrent bowel obstruction in the last 6 months, abdominal bloating and or pain in the previous 3 months, evidence of bowel obstruction on the radiographic image, no evidence of anatomic or structural abnormality. Pseudo obstruction related to decreased parasympathetic activity as in trauma, burn, recent surgery, medication, opioids, phenothiazine, clozapine, respiratory failure, electrolyte disturbance, diabetes mellitus, and uremia. Brain X-ray abdomen sternal pseudo obstruction syndrome find identical to mechanical large bowel obstruction, so it's difficult to differentiate without clinical picture. Enema radiography single contrast water soluble enema demonstrate absence of any mechanical obstruction. CT, the hallmark of colonic pseudo obstruction is the presence of dilatation of large bowel, even marked without evidence of an appropriate transition point or mechanically obstructing lesion. It's important to note, however, that a gradual transition point is frequently present, usually at or near the splenic fissure. This is examples of pseudocolonic obstruction. It's another case of pseudocolonic obstruction, marked dilated colon, all through extended to pelvic and sigmoid colon. This is table how to differentiate between localized ileus, generalized ileus, small bowel obstruction, large bowel obstruction. Localized ileus, air in the rectum or sigmoid present, air in small bowel in localized ileus 2 to 3 distended loops. In localized ileus, air in large bowel appear in rectum or sigmoid. Generalized ileus, air in rectum or sigmoid present in generalized ileus. Generalized ileus, air in small bowel, multiple distended loops. Air in large bowel, yes, distended. In generalized ileus, generalized, we found distended large small bowel loops with air present in both. Small bowel obstruction, large bowel obstruction. Small bowel obstruction, no air in rectum or sigmoid. Multiple dilated loops of small bowel, no air in large bowel. In small bowel obstruction, no air seen distal to small bowel, meaning no air in large bowel. No air in rectum or sigmoid. In large bowel obstruction, no air present in rectum or sigmoid. No air seen distal to point of obstruction. Air in large bowel seen with distended large bowel loops in large bowel obstruction. Air in small bowel none unless ileocecal valve incompetent. Decompressed large bowel obstruction into small bowel. Gastric dilatation, gastrictesia. Gastric dilatation causes. First, gastric outlet obstruction syndrome, even benign or malignant, meaning mechanical gastric outlet obstruction at pylorus or duodenum, as present in adenocarcinoma or GIST, mechanical kinking of pylorus, jejunum, or from acute obstruction of pylorus, such as from gallstone ileus. This is benign cause, although idiopathic acute gastric dilatation. This is another cause of gastric dilatation. Third cause, functional reflex paralysis of neuromuscular system, paralytic ileus. Gastric dilatation, gastric volvulus, ear swallowing, diabetes as in gastric neuropathy, surgery in gastric bypass, plant trauma, acute pancreatitis, infectious disease, thyroid disease, anorexia and nervosa. This is causes of gastrictesia. Acute gastric dilatation in a point with anorexia nervosa. Gastroparesis, functional gastric dilatation without evidence of obstruction. Gastric emphysema, we've seen linear streaks of gas within stomach gastric wall. This is functional gastric dilatation, gastroparesis. Prominent gastric dilatation, note that stomach extend into pelvis. Nasogastric tube was placed with prominent decompression and resolution of symptom. Gastric dilatation in Prader-Willi syndrome. This is gastric dilatation. This is, we found massive acute dilatation of stomach extending up to to the level of lumbar 4 and dilated jejunal lobes in a patient with lupus nephritis. Superior mesenteric artery syndrome, elevation of left hemidiaphragm, abdominal cavity show massively distended stomach, this massive distended stomach filled with numerous pieces and debris. This is also massive distended stomach. Gastric dilatation of stomach and emphysema following postpartum hemorrhage. Gastric volvulus. One cause of gastrictesia is gastric volvulus. Classic triads of Burchard in gastric volvulus: severe sudden epigastric pain, intractable retching without vomiting, inability to pass an endogastric tube. Chronic symptoms are more common in patients with mesenteric axial volvulus. Gastric volvulus, organoaxial type, stomach rotated along long axis, along cardiobiliary line. This long axis, stomach rotated along this, which is drawing from cardia and pylorus. Greater curvature being displaced superiorly. Lesser curvature located more caudally in the abdomen. This is organoaxial volvulus. Organoaxial volvulus, greater curvature displaced superiorly, lesser curvature displaced caudally in the abdomen. Rotation around cardiobiliary axis, longitudinal axis, organoaxial volvulus. Organoaxial gastric volvulus, as we see, large retrocardiac mass with air fluid level, retrocardiac mass, large hiatal hernia associated with inversion of the greater curvature superiorly, lesser curvature caudally. This is organoaxial volvulus gastroesophageal reflux, also seen with barium. Mesenteroaxial volvulus, rotation around short axis from lesser curvature to greater curvature perpendicular to the cardiopyloric line, resultant displacement of the antrum above gastroesophageal junction, displacement of the antrum above gastroesophageal junction. Mesenteroaxial, rotation around short axis from lesser to greater curvature perpendicular to cardiobiliary line, result displacement of antrum above gastroesophageal junction. This is antrum displacement, antrum displaced above gastroesophageal junction, and gastroesophageal junction being down or caudal to the pyloric antrum. Standing position showing air almost completely filling left upper quadrant of fundus and extending into right upper quadrant. Double bubble sign, two air filled structures, one and one in the upper abdomen with no air distally. Proximal bubble in the left side filled with air represent stomach. Second bubble in the right midline represent the proximal duodenum. This is duodenal obstruction. Double bubble sign with barium, two air filled structure in the upper abdomen, no air distally. Proximal bubble left side with air represent stomach. Second bubble in the right of the middle line represent proximal duodenum. This is duodenal obstruction. Extraluminal air. Extraluminal air meaning air outside bowel lumen, outside wall. This is represent pneumoperitoneum. Air in the peritoneal cavity. Pneumoperitoneum refers to the presence of free gas within peritoneal cavity in the erect abdomen. Pneumoperitoneum causes. Most common causes perforation, as in peptic ulcer disease, inflammation, perforated diverticulitis, toxic megacolon, necrotizing enterocolitis, infarction, pneumatoid coli, system rupture, malignancy, perforated carcinoma, mechanical perforation following trauma, inception. This is all causes perforation which leads to pneumoperitoneum. Second is iatrogenic, post operative as in abdominal surgery, peritoneal dialysis. Third, pneumothorax due to congenital pleuroperitoneal fistula, communication between pleural and the peritoneal cavity. Fourth, introduction bare vaginum, dushing. Radiography technique, minimal as 1 milli of free gas could be detected by proper technique. Abdomen X-ray film must contain lung field, as pulmonary consolidation or cardiac condition may mimic acute abdomen. Signs of pneumoperitoneum in supine radiograph. Right upper quadrant gas, crescent sign ear penis diaphragm, perihepatic, subhepatic Morrison's pouch. Right upper quadrant free gas site in peritoneum, pneumoperitoneum. Another sign, fissure for ligamentum teres ear present. Dog's cap sign, dog's cap sign. Regular sign, double wall sign. Regular meaning double wall sign, both serosal and the related mucosal wall of bowel delineated. It means the free air is at that serosal surface. Ligament visualization in pneumoperitoneum, falciform ligament sign, air delineating falciform ligament, umbilical inverted V sign, triangular air sign, cupola sign, football sign or air dome, a large air collection penis that do not conform to any bowel loop, continuous diaphragm sign, scrotal air in the children, decubitus abdomen sign, double bubble sign, lesser sac sign. This is signs of pneumoperitoneum supine radiograph. Signs in pneumoperitoneum. Free air under diaphragm, seen in erect film, free air under diaphragm. This is crescent sign, air penis the diaphragm, delineating diaphragm making crescent, crescent sign air penis diaphragm, erect EB abdomen, erect chest X-ray, extraluminal abdominal gas, extraluminal gas never normal but may be seen following intra-abdominal surgery or ERCP. This is decubitus abdomen signs in pneumoperitoneum. Left lateral decubitus film showing gas between the liver and abdominal wall. This is liver, abdominal wall, free gas between poles. This is represent decubitus abdomen signs. Gas in subhepatic fissure, supine abdomen, show elliptical collection of air within subhepatic space. Duct's cap sign, free air in Morrison's pouch. Supine right upper quadrant liver sign, two triangular shape, lower lateral corner, concave lateral border outlining medial border of the liver. Position inferior to the 11th rib, position superior to the right kidney. Between 11th rib, the right kidney, this is ear in Morrison pouch, which dog's cap sign. This is triangular shape, concave lateral border outlining medial border of the liver. Triangular triangular signs pneumoperitoneum, triangular GAD shadow superior to kidney, posterior inferior to the Wolf strip, Dux cap sign. Ear sitting against the ventral surface of the liver. Ear sitting against central surface of the liver in peer area. Geographical in shape, liver is a homogeneous organ, should be homogeneous in density on bleem film. Liver seen to demonstrable and even density in this sign. A regular sign, pneumoperitoneum, double wall sign. Both sides of the bowel are visible, cerusal and mucosal surface, due to presence of air intraluminal and extraluminal. One of the most common causes of pneumoperitoneum in recent surgery, abscess, regular sign. Signs of pneumoperitoneum, regular double wall sign, seen in multiple cases. Appearance of bowel wall in plain film when it's outlined by intra-extraluminal gases. Regular sign, free air outlining small bowel pneumoperitoneum. Pseudo irregular sign, both sides of wall and the dilated shape loops of bowel about each other. Differential diagnosis, free fluid in the peritoneal cavity, adjacent loop of bowel with second walls, pseudo irregular sign. Falciform ligament visualizations, falciform ligament sign, normally invisible. Visualizations of falciform ligament by free gas either side of ligament, as seen by white arrow. This is supine film, free air arise over anterior surface of the liver. This is falciform ligament sign, falciform ligament normally invisible but visible in presence of free air in peritoneal cavity. Falciform ligament from surrounding air in the pneumoperitoneum. Football sign likes massively feel air filled peritoneum to American football. Massively air filled peritoneum like American football. Supine position, free air collect anterior to the abdomen fissura, producing sharp interface with the parietal peritoneum Z bar, creating the football outline. Most open children are traumatizing enterocolitis. This is a football sign. Signs in pneumoperitoneum, falciform ligament sign, football sign present both in the same case. This is double bubble sign, two collection of overlapping gas, one of this is subdiaphragmatic and free gas, and the other is normal within fundus of the stomach, producing double bubble sign. Not luck double bubble sign in duodenal obstruction or pyloric stenosis. This is two bubble of gas, one under diaphragm, free in peritoneum, and the other in the stomach fundus. The cupola sign, arcuate dome shaped like collection, free intraperitoneal gas, penis central tendon of diaphragm. Superior border will define compared with the inferior extent of collection. This is cupola sign. Triangular sign, small triangular of gas that typically positioned between large bowel and the flank laterally. Continuous diaphragm sign, sufficient free air, left and right hemidiaphragm, cupola appears as continuous. Double bubble sign, subdiaphragmatic gas under left hemidiaphragm, two collection overlapping gas, one subdiaphragmatic free gas, and the normal gas within the fundus of the stomach. Lesser sac sign, white arrow, this is represent a cupola sign, and this is represent position the posterior to the stomach, usually peritoneal space, lesser sign. Abdominal gas compressed by free air under tension in this infant with perforated gut, pneumoperitoneum. Number of other signs of pneumoperitoneum less commonly seen: leaping dolphin sign, eureka sign, inverted V sign, air in the fissure for ligamentum medialis, coronary ligament outlined by air, pneumo gallbladder sign. Leaping dolphin sign, appearance of septum within air collection under right hemidiaphragm, probably outlining costal muscle sleeves of the hemidiaphragm rather than representing outlining of bowel wall, negative silhouette of the liver. Condition simulating pneumoperitoneum: Hallett syndrome, intestine between liver and diaphragm, subphrenic abscess, curvilinear subdiaphragmatic pulmonary collapse, subdiaphragmatic fat, cyst pneumatosis intestinalis, subpulmonary pneumothorax. Charlotte syndrome, intestine between liver and diaphragm. This is pseudopneumoperitoneum. Right-sided subphrenic abscess. Bubble of gas in abscess subspecies that they are not clearly contained with a normal bowel. Abscess with air looking like pseudopneumoperitoneum. Condition simulating pneumoperitoneum: large poly at the base, large emphysematous poly at the base of the right lung mimics large pneumoperitoneum. This is identify air contrasted liver, air contrasted costal muscle sleeve marked with white arrow, pneumothorax, right hemidiaphragm contrasted with air in the pleural space, limbic liver contrasted with free air in peritoneum, colonic interposition, Salis syndrome, this is also simulating pneumoperitoneum, air above diaphragm rather than under, this is right-sided pneumothorax simulating with deep sulcus sign, simulating pneumoperitoneum, hydropneumoperitoneum. Hydropneumoperitoneum, radiographic diagnosis of hydropneumoperitoneum: air fluid level in the abdominal cavity in the upright or decubitus view of the abdomen. Generalized hydropneumoperitoneum causes: perforation of GIT tract impatient to have underlying ascites due to either renal failure or carcinomatosis, rupture of intestinal anastomosis, perforation of the peptic ulcer with resultant bioneumoperitoneum, blunt abdominal trauma causing laceration of the solid organ and perforation of the hollow viscus, hemoneumoperitoneum. Hydropneumoperitoneum, bioneumoperitoneum, hemoneumoperitoneum. This is meaning fluid with air in peritoneal cavity. Hydropneumoperitoneum, multiple air fluid levels seen in the abdomen. Hydropneumoperitoneum cases seen under left diaphragmatic copula. Extra luminal air, another pneumoretroperitoneum, retroperitoneum, not pneumoperitoneum. Pneumoretroperitoneum is always abnormal. Pneumoretroperitoneum caused by perforated retroperitoneal hollow viscus. Most common cause of pneumoretroperitoneum is perforation of the second, third, fourth portion of the duodenum, ascending descending colon secondary to trauma, diverticulitis or ulceration, rectum surgery, endoscopy, trauma. This is most common causes of pneumoretroperitoneum injury or caused by retroperitoneal organs or structures. Pneumoretroperitoneum features streaky linear appearance outlining retroperitoneal structures, mottled blotchy appearance, relatively fixed position. Pneumoretroperitoneum most often seen right side, where air can outline right kidney and under surface of the liver, may outline psoas muscle, kidneys, ureters, bladder, aorta, IVC, subphrenic spaces, structures in retroperitoneum space. This is pneumoretroperitoneum with gas outlining right psoas muscles. This is abdominal X-ray supine position, irregular gas image observed in the right lateral abdomen corresponding to pneumoretroperitoneum in emphysematous cholecystitis. This is massive amount of air surrounding kidney consistent with pneumoretroperitoneum ERCP causing this iatrogenic, causing duodenal perforation. This is pneumoretroperitoneum misinterpreted as herniated intervertebral disc. Unusual presentation of perforation of ascending cancer colon. This is a free air in the retroperitoneal space, air seen surrounding lateral border of the right kidney. Differential diagnosis of pneumoretroperitoneum. Differential diagnosis include air in the retroperitoneum do not move freely with the change in position. Gas can extend up into mediastinum or neck because there is no barrier between both. Try an erect and decubitus view to see if the gas moves. If the gas is seen to move, it is not in the retroperitoneum. Pseudo-pneumoretroperitoneum is a radiographic finding of gas within the abdominal region that mimics appearance of pneumoretroperitoneum. Causes of pseudo-pneumoretroperitoneum include pneumoperitoneum, subcutaneous emphysema, subhepatic splenic abscess, renal sinus fat, excessive retroperitoneal adiposity, psoas muscle fat. Intraluminal gas, meaning air in the wall of the bowel as in pneumatosis intestinalis. Intramural gas, air in the wall of the bowel. Pneumatosis coli, air in the wall of the bowel with linear areas as an obstruction, infection, ischemia, necrosis following colonoscopy. Gas tracks along the bowel wall appearing linear, which is usually submucosal, around the cystic public collection subserosal, creating rings. The joint may outline circumferential margin of the bowel. Intramural gas, small bowel infarction and perforation. This is wall air in the wall of the bowel. Intramural gas, necrotizing enterocolitis, found air in the wall of the bowel. Air in the wall of the bowel. Small bowel infarction, we found intramural gas. This is dilated stomach with abnormal wall pattern effaced. Intramural gas along greater curvature of the stomach. Irregular bubbles of line of gas within bowel wall separate from bowel content immediately above iliac crest. Branching gas pattern in the liver, either toward central region of the liver, gas within the biliary tree, pneumopilia, not omenias, in gallstone ileus, duodenal arsenal perforation, postoperative status, normal of sphincter of Oddi incompetence, or branching gas pattern of the liver toward the periphery of the liver, gas within the portal vein. Omenia sign, mesenteric infarction, emphysematous cholecystitis. This is gas in the biliary tree, air toward region of the liver, toward central region of the liver, one of two tube-like branching lucences in the right upper quadrant, Find to the location of the major bile duct. Yellow arrow indicate gas in the biliary duct system after gallstone passage. This is air noted within 2 cm from liver capsule and in the peripheral region of the liver rather than central numerous branching structure hepatic portal vein gases. Hepatic portal vein gases solid and arrow and white. Black arrow identify what's probably fat within the bladder gullet, but this is free air. Air in the hepatic portal venous gas by white arrow. Hepatic portal venous gas, there is evidence of intramural gas seen. Extensive hepatic portal venous gas, there is multiple air fluid level within the bowel suggesting motility disorder. Combined xanthogranulomatous and emphysematous intestinalis, lucent arc in the upper bowl of calyces of the left kidney, gas in the urinary tract. Gas in the urinary tract either in the kidney as emphysematous bielonephritis, emphysematous bilitis, abscess, peripherenic emphysema, iatrogenic in surgery, infarction in renal carcinoma, penetrating trauma, reno-GIT fistula as in the diverticulitis Crohn's neoplasm. Air in the scrotum as in abscess or Fournier gangrene. Air in the renal bladder as emphysematous cystitis, iatrogenic in surgery, penetrating trauma, vesico-GIT fistula. Air in the ureter as in vesico-ureteral reflux of bladder gas, urethro-GIT fistula. Emphysematous bielonephritis, gas in the right kidney with striated appearance and decreasing of perinephric fat. Vesico-ureteral reflux of bladder gas, air, bielogram, as well as massive bladder gas from emphysematous cystitis. Gas in urinary tract, in kidneys caused by emphysematous bielonephritis, emphysematous bielitis, abscess, perinephric emphysema, iatrogenic in surgery, infarction in renal carcinoma, retreating trauma, renal GIT fistula as in diverticulitis, Crohn's, neoplasm. Air gas in scrotum as in abscess for near gangrene. Gas in urinary bladder as emphysematous cystitis, iatrogenic surgery, retreating trauma, vesico-GIT fistula. Gas in ureter as in vesico-ureteral reflux of bladder gas, urethro-GIT fistula. Combined xanthogranulomatous and emphysematous bielonephritis, lucent arc in the upper pole calyces of the left kidney. Emphysematous bielonephritis, gas in right kidney with striated appearance, crescent of perinephric fat. Vesico-ureteral reflux of bladder gas, air bielogram, as well as massive bladder gas from emphysematous cystitis. Emphysematous cystitis, gas in the bladder wall. Emphysematous cystitis, gas in the urinary bladder wall. Emphysematous cystitis, air without urinary tract in the kidneys, air throughout urinary tract in kidneys, ureter, bladder. Thank you for listening.